The following is an extremely well-paid commercial advertisement and not a really funny cartoon.
Are you ready to make them doom cups pay, Blissey?
I'm ready to crush literal baby toys, Ari!
Alright, Sheilas, prepare to be sent back to the factory with a few pieces missing.
Wow, girl, I'm Maddie. I'm like totally grumpy all the time, and I don't like Mary to press all the buttons even though she's the best announcer ever.
Really, Mary Sue? You couldn't even attempt to stay in character?
Okay, I was in character. That's what just sounds like in my head. And if it's in my head, then it must be...
Surprise ambush!
Crash, boom, terrible things, blood, gore, murder.
What in the world are you dafties doing?
Well, nice to know that when I give you professionals downtime, you don't do something stupid with it. Like playing with dolls.
First of all, honey, shame on you for not recognizing the differences between dolls and action figures.
Action player companions, gorsk.
What he said. Second, they're the new TF2 Analysis Anarchy action figures, to be precise. Manco sent over a box of prototypes for us to test out and see if they truly appeal to those with a childlike sense of wonder and a taste for video game violence.
I'm the child!
I'm the violence!
I'm chaotic neutral, I think!
I literally had nothing to do today. Oh, and wait till you see the commercial.
Commercial? What commercial?
This commercial.
Oh, what fresh Tartarus is this?
All the way from Mancup, the geniuses who brought you the Man Melter, the Dragon's Fury, and the Conniver's Kunai,
sucks.
Comes the all-new Team Fortress 2 Analysis Anarchy action figures. Collect them all. Balto, Matchstick, Steve Irwin, Firefly, Princess Merida, Barty Crouch Jr., Emily Blunt, Angry Video Game Nerd Pone, Skittles Mascot, Michelangelo, John Cleese, Fix-It Felix, and Stantler. Those are their names, right? You're not making those up? Line? Each comes with four accessories and says 18 mantastic phrases.
Let's say upwards of 17 mantastic phrases instead. It sounds more impressive.
Okay then. Four accessories and says upwards of 17 mantastic phrases when you boot their noses.
Why do you want me to say it's good to be helping? You have 3 seconds to get that microphone out of my face, or you're gonna find out what a magical enema feels like.
I fear for my body and everything attached to it.
I've been waiting for 6 hours. Where's my pizzas?
This is my off-duty time!
In addition, these marvelous mercenaries are fireproof, waterproof, unbreakable, and add hours upon hours of fun for any pony ages 10 and up. Fillies and colts, ask for them by name.
Mommy, can I go home now? I don't know who these ponies are.
Not until Mommy gets that paycheck, sweetie. Now do the cute song and dance I taught ya.
And look out this spring for our new supporting cast action figures. Undertaker, the spiteful Australian Toll Bean, Trogdor, Ringo Starr, Snow Miser and Heat Miser, and... the new Super Ultra Bestest Limited Edition Mary Sue figure with strawberry scent and realistic amazingness.
Do I want to know how you managed to put in all those special features?
I got systems.
Hello, kiddies.
Cheated them!
Aw, I wanted to play too.
G'day, darlings.
Oh, sweet Celestia, is that what I sound like?
So why just sit there chewing on your own tongue when you can get your hooves on the new Team Fortress 2 Analysis Anarchy action figures? By Manco. We sell products and get in fights.
Tap to AA action dolls. Mumble, mumble, fine print, legal disclaimers no one ever pays attention to.
Thank you.
Well, you two certainly make a compelling proposal, and these certainly are impressive. However, I fail to see what it is you wish to accomplish by selling these toys.
Duh! Merchandising, Doc! Where the real money from the series is made!
We take the series' name and slap it onto everything!
Analysis Anarchy the T-shirt!
Analysis Anarchy the breakfast cereal!
Analysis Anarchy the graphic novel!
Analysis Anarchy the underwear! Available in Thespio Blue and Mary Sue Pink.
We'll just pencil that as undecided.
Analysis Anarchy the Musical! Soon to be touring in Manhattan, West Applewood, and Philadelphia.
Analysis Anarchy the Flamethrower!
The kids love this one.
Give me that.
As much as I appreciate all of the effort that went into this presentation, where'd you get the assets to even film this commercial? Wasn't this supposed to be Miss Bliss's downtime?
I told you he'd be onto us! Scatter!
Look, I'm sorry, you two, but the cost to produce all of these products en masse would dip too much into our arsenal budget. Besides, Miss Bliss sells TF2 Analysis brand badges, prints, and posters at every convention she attends anyway. I don't think we're in dire need of more merchandising than what we already do.
Oh.
You know, kinda wish you reminded us of that before we got all these products made. And trust me, you do not want to know what I had to do to get the undies cleared with PR.
Well, if we can't do the new merchandising thing, how else are you gonna pay us for more episodes of us coming down here to literally kill each other for the sick, twisted amusement of others that we somehow unanimously agreed to do and pretty much ignored the very concept of having a conscience?
It might actually be less strenuous for us if we maybe set up a Patreon for the series and offer our fans and viewers rewards for their support to keep things running more efficiently. You know, things like sneak peeks at upcoming scripts, work-in-progress video clips from the visual editors, perhaps even offer some custom comics for the higher-tier patrons made by Jasper Pie himself.
Ignoring the fact I just realized you're hypocritically violating your own no-meta-fourth-wall-breaking rule, yeah, I think we can work with that.
Yeah, fine.
Can we at least keep the action figures, though?
I don't see why not.
Yeah! Every pony wins!
Now, to all you viewers out there currently watching, I would like to make a more personal appeal.
See? Right there! He's doing it again! He's only proving my point!
Wow. I'm a pie, and even I find that two-faced.
Shush. As I was saying, Thespio, Jasper Pie, and Brass Polish have been instrumental in adding far greater variety and scope to our audio, with Blissey consistently improving the visuals with every new project she tackles, which has certainly led to more entertaining productions overall.
I'm not apologizing.
Neither are we!
But the time required for each new project to reach that same level of quality has also grown quite a bit over the years. For those who are unaware, I have been paying for both audio and visual editing on the TF2 Analysis project as commissions for several years now, using funds acquired directly from fans via the Dr. Wolf Patreon, even providing a higher pay rate as productions became more complicated. The Red vs. Blue multi-parter is by far the most expensive commission in the history of my channel, and well worth every penny. However, during 2020, because of how much it took to cover for Red vs. Blue, it dipped into Patreon funds built up from 2019, 2018, and even as far back as 2017. While there were more fans directly supporting my channel back when Friendship is Magic was still in full swing, there has been a sharp decline ever since the show came to an end. The entirety of the Patreon funds ever since its inception has only been for the channel, including attending conventions, commissioning audio and visual talent, and the very occasional piece of new equipment. Because the convention scene has slowed way down since 2020, there has been far less spent on travel expenses. But even with this drop in spending, The Patreon funds have been falling month by month, with far less coming in than going out. This was thoroughly discussed with Thespio, Jasper, Blissey, and Firebrand during BabsCon 2022. Everyone very much wishes to continue producing TF2 Analysis content. In Jasper and Thespio's words, "You'll never be rid of us." I would very much like to make sure they are still properly and fairly compensated for their time and effort to keep up with the variety and scope of our previous projects. But with the Dr. Wolf Patreon as it is now, there simply won't be enough to keep up in the long term. I have also been personally bound by a promise I made to my lady many years ago, that my YouTube channel would not be a burden on any of our personal finances. And as such, I have also kept up a promise I made to myself that all Patreon funds received would only go towards building and maintaining the channel. It is with all this in mind that I hope many of you will consider visiting the new TF2 Analysis Anarchy Patreon page to see each of the rewards being offered for each support tier. Every little bit helps to show your support in this large group project we all care dearly about. Thank you kindly to each and every one of you who have kept encouraging us to create more content all these years. And here's looking forward to even more explosive shenanigans in the years to come. I am Dr. Wolf, and I...
Actually, Doc, the more I think about it, you know this isn't the first time you broke your own no-meta rule, right? Because unconsciously or not, it's all gonna come and bite you in the tail sooner or later.
Hey, this was an advertisement and had no ties to any established story arc. Therefore, it is an exception to the rule.
You'll be sorry!
Not in this life or the next.